Hey, Luke here with catsandcarp.com, and me and my boys here are doing the ultimate catfishing rod review video. I'm also going to be giving away this Big Cat Fever spinning rod at the end of this video, so stay tuned to win. Okay, so a couple things make this rod review video really special. First off, we have almost every single catfishing rod on the market here behind us today. 24 rods. Going from cheapest to most expensive, let me introduce you. We got the Bass Pro Cat Buster, the Meat Hunter, the Cabelas Cat King, the Daiwa Beefstick, the Ugly Stik Catfishing Rod, the Rippin Lips Rod, the Ugly Stik GX2, the Bn'M Silver Cat, the Berkley GlowStick, the Berkley E-Cat. We have the Bass Pro CatMaxx, the Denali Bottom Feeder, Tangling with Catfish Spinning Rod, the Shatter Cat's Rod, the Okuma Battle Cat, Whisker Seeker, the Chad Ferguson Series, Warrior Cat, Abu Garcia Catfish Commando, Big Cat Fever, Heavy Action, and two Medium Heavy Actions, Team Catfish Thundercats, the Mojo Cat from St. Croix, and the Railsplitter. The other thing that makes this special is that I am not sponsored by anyone. I'm beholden to no one. The third thing that makes this video special is that I'm bringing in other people, other cat fishermen, to help give me their opinions as well. Right now I'm going to be doing a broad overview video, giving you my opinions and about which rods I like the most, which ones I really don't like. Later on I'm going to be going through and doing specific videos on each rod and giving you a lot more detail about their stats and their pros and their cons. But for right now, without further ado, let's talk about buying fishing rods. When shopping for a fishing rod, buy a rod based on what you want to cast, not what you want to catch. All of these rods here are beefy enough to handle a trophy catfish, but each one is designed to throw different types of weight. This Ugly Stik GX2, for instance, really shouldn't be throwing more than about 1.5 to 2 ounces of lead. This Big Cat Fever Heavy Action rod can throw up to 16 ounces of lead, but really shouldn't be throwing things less than 2 ounces. Pick the rod that's going to throw whatever sort of rig and weight and bait you need to be throwing. When you're picking a rod, castability is another issue. If you only need to cast 60 yards or less, any of these rods will get the job done. If you need to start casting beyond 60 yards, then you start need to think about the rod length. Generally speaking, the longer the rod, the more distance you can get. The trade-off is the longer rods are more cumbersome. Another thing to consider is whether you want a bait casting rod or a spinning rod. Now, if you want to find out more about the pros and cons of each, check out this video I did on that subject about a month ago. I'll put a link in the description. Okay, without further ado, let's get into the rod review. So, out of all 24 rods, there was one rod that took the cake, best of show. Everybody has oohed and awed over this rod. It's the St. Croix Mojo Cat. It's $160 just for the rod. This is not a cheap rod. And I came this close to not including it in the review. I don't like St. Croix rods, and I thought this thing looked overpriced. I didn't like the looks of it, and I've never met anyone who's actually used it before. But I included it in the review just to make it a good review. And everyone's loved this thing. You've been feeling a lot of rods today. What do you think?
I think I like this St. Croix.
You do?
Truth. This thing, it's a pretty rod. I'm not crazy about the color, but the feel, it's light, nice and strong. I casted it once, and it casts really nice.
Yeah, so you like the St. Croix Mojo Cat?
Oh yeah, St. Croix Mojo is one of my favorites too. With the, what is this, the Ying Mang, I believe?
Yeah, the Ming Yang.
It's one of my favorites. I'm definitely gonna buy one of these. I love the way this thing works. And it's so lightweight, but it's still really strong. You know what I mean? It's got real nice whip action to it too.
So what do you think of that St. Croix?
It's my favorite rod, bro. All the rods there are nice, you know, but this one here is really good.
Now is it 160 bucks? Awesome.
Yeah, 160 bucks, awesome, man.
What made the Mojo Cat such a popular rod is it's extremely light in the hand. You could bass fish with this rod without any problem. It's so light. It's one of the lightest catfish rods here. And it throws up to 8 ounces of lead. So despite being a lightweight, it is extremely strong. It's got a great bend, a great action, and It just feels good in the hand. If you're looking for a good, cheap, affordable rod, a lot of people automatically think ugly sticks. And that's what I thought too, but it's not the case. There are some really great options that are just as good as ugly sticks, but cheaper. So let me show you three of my favorites. Okay, so here we've got the Bass Pro Shop Cat Buster for $24, the Meat Hunter Rod for $25, and the Cabela's King Cat for $29. Both the Ugly Stick Catfish Rod and the Ugly Stick GX2 both retail for $39.99. Now, of course, you can find these rods at different prices when they're on sale and stuff, but three rods that are a lot cheaper than the Ugly Stick, which I prefer over the Ugly Sticks. The Cabela's King Cat was hands down the most popular among all the people I showed these rods to. A lot of them preferred this over the Ugly Stick.
This Cabela right here, it's a nice rod. Nice rod. It's got good stiffness, it's got a good reaction, it's a good rod. Like
so if you're on a budget, you think that would be the one you'd pick right there, the Cabela's?
What does that go for? Absolutely.
Now, I have no problem with Ugly Stick rods. They're a good, dependable company. What you see is what you get. But there's some really good options. They are certainly not the cheapest, and they're not the only low-end game in town. I'm a huge fan of the Rippin Lips rod. This is a really attractive, high-quality catfishing rod, a serious catfishing rod, and it's the exact same price as the Ugly Stick. So if you're looking at a rod that's going to be able to handle some 30-pound fish, that's pretty hardcore, you know, I would definitely go with the Rippin Lips over the Ugly Stick. Additionally, it doesn't have the inserts and the eyelets, which are one of the first things to break on my rods. And so it's a little bit, probably a little bit longer lasting rod too. One of my absolute favorite rods in this entire collection, just if you were just say, which rod do I want to have in my hand, which one do I just enjoy the most, the Bn'M Silver Cat is way up there. I dig this rod. And after this review, I may be buying a bunch of these. So this just really slender in the hand, and it's got this paracord wrapped handle that is just really lightweight and just, it's just nice. I really hate cork handle and these oversized EV foam handles. This is a sexy rod, and it feels super light. It's one of our lightest rods here, and it's just got a great action to it. And it's $44. So this thing's only basically $5 more than an Ugly Stick, and it's one of my favorite rods in this entire collection. Now, if you're in a situation where you're looking to spend about $70, $80 for a really nice rod, there's two types of rods I would gravitate towards. If you want a light duty rod for like lake fishing, slow water fishing, where you're only throwing like 2 to 4 ounces of lead, the Whisker Seeker is hands down my favorite. And this is the rod I've been using on my boat for the last 2 years. It's got this super sexy slim composite handle. It's like part rubber, part cork. It's got a great look to it. It's got that, I believe it's the S-glass material on it, but it doesn't handle the big leads that well. Now, they make a heavy action of this rod, but I haven't tested that one out. If you're fishing big rivers and you need to be throwing 10-ounce leads, 8-ounce leads, you know, the really big stuff, these are the two rods I would be looking at, and it's like one of these too close to call things. The Big Cat Fever medium heavy action and the Shatter Cat heavy action are really equivalent rods. Okay, this one's $84, this one's $74. They're both made with very high quality components, these really beefy durable eyes, metal reel seats, great materials all around, slightly different looks and color schemes. The Shatter Cat rod is thinner and a lighter blank, and the Big Cat Fever is more heavy duty, and it's got that beefier, chunkier feel to it. Additionally, the Big Cat Fever comes in a heavy action, so if you need to throw like 14-ounce leads, you can get an even heavier duty version of this. The Shatter Cat only comes in one size. The Big Cat Fever also offers 10 grand to anybody who catches a state record with one of their rods. So, you know, it's whatever you want on there. They're both excellent rods, and it's just a matter of preference. Now, out of these 24 rods, almost every single one of them's an awesome rod. You know, there's something great about almost all of these. However, there are some weirdos. The Daiwa Beefstick is a weird freaking fishing rod. This thing bends more at the reel seat than it does in the middle of the rod. It has the crappiest action I have ever felt in my life. And I don't think it's that strong. It weighs a metric ton. It feels like there's lead in this rod. And it just, I'm gonna have to do a crazy video where I see what it takes to break this thing. But there's people like Leo from Extreme Philly Fishing. He's a fan of these things. The other rod in this collection that's a little bit of a head scratcher is the Team Catfish Thundercat. This is a $90 rod, 90 bucks. And it's eclipsed only by the St. Croix and the Railsplitter for price. So this is one of the most expensive catfishing rods you can buy. And let's compare it to the Bass Pro Shot $24 Cat Buster here. I mean, they look almost exactly identical. The Bass Pro Shop Cat Buster and the Team Catfish, they both have the same foam handle, the same cheap plastic reel seat. They've got really similar eyelets. They look the same color scheme. The Team Catfish is a little long, a little thicker. And if you go on their website, you can, the Team Catfish say this is made out of e-glass, which is a more expensive material. And I'm pretty sure this is just fiberglass. But to be honest, they weigh about the same. This one's stiffer, but like, I just don't get it. I mean, it's a perfectly fine rod for like $30, you know? You basically make this thing out of fiberglass and it would be the exact same rod as this $24 rod. Well, at any rate, I hope you liked this video. I hope you learned something new and this gave you some ideas when you're buying your next catfishing rod. Remember, we're gonna keep putting out videos where we profile individual rods and give you a whole lot more details. But at any rate, I promised that I was gonna give away this rod. This is the Smart Tap rod from Tackle Box, and Mr. Luis Harley Aguilar is our winner. And I left a comment on your comment. Message me your contact information and I will make sure to send this rod out to you. If you want to win the Big Cat Fever medium heavy action spinning rod, leave a comment, click subscribe, and make sure to share this video on any social media platform. And I'll pick the winner 1 week from today. So at any rate, thanks for watching, and I hope you like this video. Hey guys, no more sword fighting with the rods. And remember,
like, subscribe!
That's right!